TOA community, what's up everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Robert Linkul, trainingtheolderadult.com. I wanted to talk to you a little bit about this video that I put up yesterday about fall prevention and strategies on, well, thoughts on why people fall and what we need to work on as strength coaches and as individuals to help our clients not fall down. Okay, so let's go a little piece by piece here. We'll break into this and see what you think. And I got a little demonstration behind me. I wanna make sure everybody understands what we're talking about. What I mean by fall prevention is we are training our... clients as they get older to not be a spinning top. The spinning top is in perfect balance. The second it gets out of balance, it wobble wobble. Basically how the aging body starts to develop. 45, deconditioned a little bit. 65, very deconditioned, and so on. And what happens to their gait? 3 feet plus, 2.5, 2 feet, 1.5, 1 foot. When your 8-inch foot and your 8-inch foot takes a step, you're not even taking 8 inches distance in between your own feet. I have a client asked me about this yesterday. She goes, how far should I be stepping? Ideally, in between your back foot and your front foot. If you could just get your 1 foot beyond the toe of the other foot, we'd be winning. Can't do that. That's her walking pattern. She's one of those wind-up toys because she can't balance when her toes are straight. So she has to turn her feet out, more of a waddler now when she walks, which you saw the spinning top. The second you get out of balance, what happened? Wobble, wobble, slam. Okay, so referring back to this, okay, the out of balance component and the spinning top, I feel like is a really good analogy for this, okay? I'm not talking about asymmetries of what someone's body actually looks like. I'm talking about the base in which we are designed. Ideally, if we're taking long strides when we walk, let's say 3 of our foot lengths, okay? From my back heel to my front toe up to my shoulders makes what, right? It makes a triangle. Everybody see that? But if I invert that, basically, if my shoulders are the widest point and my feet take these tiny little steps, what am I now? I'm this little wobbling top. Does that make sense, right? So as we get older, it's not simply because you're frail. It's not simply because you're weak. It's not simply because you're deconditioned. It's all of those things minus age, okay? Age is not a correlation to weakness in small steps in a short gait. It isn't. Who are the people that are most unstable, most likely to fall, experiencing the falls, etc.? It's deconditioned older adults. Deconditioned is the key component to this, right? So it's not just like, oh, I gotta prevent myself from falling as I age. No, you have to be in shape enough not to fall down is the whole point of this message. And we do that simply by resistance training at a base level to get your bones and your muscles strong and coordinated. And if you can keep your muscles and your bones strong and coordinated, you'll be able to continue to take long strides like you did when you were 20, 30, 40, and 50. But because you were deconditioned that entire time and then going into your aging years, your body is now losing the battle to gravity. It's not as hormonally responsive as it was when you were younger. So your body's ability to produce more dense bone, hold on to its muscle mass, increase any stimulation of energy and cognition and everything else that is done hormonally. I'm not an expert on that, right? But what I'm telling you is everything starts to slow down unless you continue to strengthen the system and encourage the system with these daily or at least every other day energy boost of exercising, right? So if you can keep your body strong, and now there are gait correlations and fall reduction risks on machines, everybody, on machines. You don't even have to do free weights. You don't have to do anything that even remotely simulates walking as a gait. It's not like you have to do lunges and step-ups and loaded carries. You can, for sure, you should, right? But it doesn't mean that you have to. The research shows simply doing machines like quad extension, hamstring curl, leg press, row, push, pull. 5-6 exercises, it takes you 12 or 15 minutes every other day. 3 days a week would be awesome, okay? Can you find 45 minutes in your entire week 168 hours. I'm not even asking for one. I'm asking for 45 minutes, three 15-minute blocks where you run around those machines and do three sets of 12, three sets of 15 on each one really quick. Like literally that can maintain a bone density, a muscle mass, and help you maintain your gait as you age. Now, would you benefit, greatly benefit from doing more? Absolutely, okay? But at a base minimum, you'd be winning right there. So what is the goal? Okay, no laughing at my socks. I did this so everybody could see, okay? Because black shoes, as you see, all my shoes are black. On black flooring is very difficult to see. So our back cone here, my foot is 13 inches, okay? So there's one of my foot lengths from my back heel to my front toe. I have this indicated with three of my foot lengths for you so you can see this. So I'm gonna line up my back heel, and as I take a step, I should be able to get to three lengths of my foot. So basically the back heel of shoe number one to the front toe of shoe number three, I should be able to fit one of my feet in between my own stride steps. Now, is that the first or the second step? Typically not, okay? Those are two steps that are used for acceleration. And they might be a little smaller, and then I'm in full stride length, typically by the third step, okay? By the third step, I'm now into a full stride, and I should be able to get this, what I'm talking about here. So if we measure that, 13, 26, 39 inches in stride length. When I am in a full stride, which we've measured, we chalked our feet, Keegan and I did this, we chalked our feet and we walked across the floor. And then we measured in between those. And I was 40 inches with my right foot and 42 inches with my left foot. So I'm an inch over what I want as a minimum on one, and I'm 3 inches over on the other one, okay? And the purpose for that is, number one, I have good strength and stability and mobility through my hips. Even though I've had three hip replacements, I've had back surgeries, I've worked on this to be able to do these lifts, to be able to keep my body strong to where walking like this is still possible. So at a base level, strength-wise, I should be able to maintain this stride length forever. When you hit 70, all of a sudden, it's like, hey, you're 70 now. Now you have to walk like this. Now we have to be the wind-up toy where you round over forward and you can take these little Roboto steps, right? Where I can barely get one of my, these are 6-inch steps, everybody, okay? Half of my foot length. And then what we see from there is the toes go out because we don't have a stability anymore that allows us to keep our toes straight. Now we only have support forward and back. So side to side is a real issue. So what do? We lower down a little bit and then we turn our toes out, and now, okay, now I've got some stability to go side to side. But I have to take these little wobbly steps. But then again, how small my feet are versus how wide my shoulders are, as soon as I get out of balance, what's happening? Wobble, wobble, slam, I'm done. So just because you're aging, just because you're getting older, does not mean you have to take small steps. You're taking small steps because you're deconditioned. So how do we fix it? Number one, if you're not resistance training, start. Your body needs to get stronger. If you are deconditioned. Get your body strong. If you simply say, coaches and clients out there, if you simply say, take bigger steps, they're gonna fall down. You cannot do that. It's obvious you can't do that. You've already been showing us all you can't do that, or else you would currently be doing it. So you need to train this back into your body's ability. I would suggest finding a coach or a trainer, somebody that can work with you to help you do that. But at bare minimum, okay, step number one is just start resistance training. It could be machines, it could be selectorized equipment, it could be free weights, whatever you want, just do it safely and do it with progressive overload. If you don't know what progressive overload is, look at any of my previous videos. You'll see it in there. We hammer that fact home pretty hard. Load that is challenging. Not impossible, but challenging. So get your body strong and start to get conditioned. And then as you start to practice your gait, this is your walking stride. That's what we mean by gait. Think about heel striking softly and rolling through your foot and taking just enough ground contact with that to propel you forward. Now, that sounds very simple, and you're like, don't we do that already? Most people, when they do their waddle step, their feet go flat, 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 flat. Everything's kind of hitting the ground at the same time. But if you simply say, I'm going to heel and roll through my foot, it already propels me forward to take a tiny bit bigger step anyhow. So if I continue to do that over and over and over again, okay, with each strike, I'm gonna roll through my foot, through my foot, through my foot. It starts to propel me forward naturally. And if that can be 2 inches or 3 inches further than I normally stride, that's great. But you need to cognitively make this decision every time you go to walk. Because I saw this with my dad, he would be in here and he would walk like this, right? Waddle, shifty, side to side. I would give him a weight in one hand and something would happen. He would lower his center of mass and he would have to push off the ground to get this weight to go. And we said, okay, if he's muscularly engaged and cognitively focused on the task at hand, he does it proper. So instead of saying, here's a weight, carry it wherever you go, let's at least do the second one. Let's at least do the cognitive engagement. Okay, I'm about to walk to the car. Let me think about this. How do I want my feet to go? Do I just autonomically go, all right, here we go. I'll meet you at the car, everybody, right? Or do I go, what would we say? Oh yeah, I gotta push off, okay? Heel, push off, push off, push off, push off. Even if you look silly, even if you look like you're ice skating, right? Like you're sliding across the floor as you're going, I'm pushing off, pushing off, pushing off. You know what you're doing? You're taking a longer stride. You are training your body to do this correctly. And by doing that over and over and over again, that will then become the autonomic way in which you walk. And so now, when you're not trying so hard, you just autonomically start to kind of push off through your foot stride and you walk semi-capably normal in terms of not waddling, not shifting side to side, and not taking less than at least 1 foot length. So what's your goal now? Let's do this one here real quick too, and then we'll call it a day. What's your goal now? If this is what you currently do, okay? You currently take this step, let's just say 12 inches so we have easy math, right? I'm 12 inches on the right, 12 on the left, but I've done 6 inches. I'm half my shoe length. So if that's how I currently walk, 6 inches, okay? I want you to shoot for 9 inches. I want you to shoot for a little bit further stride length with each one of these, 2 to 3 inches. That should be your goal right now. And if that goes well, I want you to try to shoot for 12 inches. So at least your back heel lines up with the front toe. So now we're taking a even or a neutral position. Then we progress to the point where you can step 3 inches beyond your toe with your rear heel. So that would become our goal then, to get 3 inches in between our toes. And then we take that to 3 inches, 6 inches, 9 inches, and eventually we have 12 inches to where your other foot can fit in between. That is the ultimate goal. How long will that take? 2 weeks? No. This could be a year or years of work, because it's taking you years to get deconditioned. It's taking you years to how you used to walk like this, and then in your 40s and 50s, and then late 50s, 60s, and then 65, 70, 75, 80. Now that's how we shuffle about, if we're lucky. Can we reverse engineer this? Absolutely. Is it gonna take some work? Yeah, for sure. But can you do it? 100%. You can do it and see improvement in as little as one training session. We have clients, the same client who does the Roboto walk, right? When she's in here and she's focused and she's doing it right, she walks very efficiently, doesn't waddle as much, and looks very stable doing so. We train, we hug, she goes to leave, autonomic power goes back on, it's time to go, waddle, 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 and I go, hey, show me your good walking gait. Oh, that's right, stride, 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 stride. So you have to be cognitively invested in improving this if you want to. But don't accept age as this is just who I am now. I'm old. This is how old people walk. That's horseshit. Do not accept that. I don't accept it. Research supports that's not accurate. Are we all on a decline after age, technically 35, but really 50 is where you really start to see things kind of curve down? Yeah. Okay. You're not going to have the speed, the mobility, and the length of your stride at 80 that you had at your 20. You're just not going to. But does it have to be this? Do you have to be this big of a fall risk? No. So we should, ideally, take at least, okay, at least your back foot, this is my toe, and my front heel. At least you should be clearing your own foot length, okay? If not, 3 inches, 6 inches, 9 inches, 12 inches, now I have a whole foot of mine. Now, if you're a size 8, all this goes to 8 inches, 8 inches, 8 inches, right? It's whatever your foot length is, not 12 inches or not my foot length. It's not a foot measuring, it's your foot, okay? So if you're a size 7, it's 7, 14, 21 inches from your back heel to your front toe. That's your goal. That's the goal. Don't just go out there and try to do that immediately. You know why? You're not capable of doing it, so you're probably going to fall down. If you were capable of doing it, you'd already be doing it. So you have deconditioned yourself into this top. Now, let's re-engineer you back out to at least being kind of boxy. Let's at least get to the point where as wide as your shoulders are, that's how long of a length, stride length that you can take. And that could be a very good goal. And that can help you square up your stability. The more stable you are, the now faster your gait can be. The slower the gait, if you're less than a second, like a measured second per step, you have a very high likelihood of falling down. Most people can take a step, you know, every 3/4 of a second or 2/3 of a second, something like that. Okay. Step, 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 step. I mean, people can walk pretty efficiently. They can have a pretty high turnover, a half a second. So if you can do a step at least one every second, we're good. It could be better, but that's fine. But if you're taking more than a second, 1/1000, 2/1003, that's really slow. You're having stability issues for sure. Your body's working hard to try to not fall down. Let's address this. Let's re-engineer it. If you don't know how, find someone or message me below. I'll help you find someone. Okay. We have ambassadors all over the place. We're growing. Our TOA people are growing. We have certified pros all over the place. I think we're in 28 different states now, 4 different countries now, actually, Ireland, Iceland, England, Canada, Mexico. Oh man, where's our other guy out there? Damn it, I'm missing one out in, it's not Japan, it's, there's another one out there. We got one guy out there all by himself. I can't think of the place. So that's 6 different countries. Yeah, I think that's everybody. We might have another guy that was Italian. I don't know if he passed or not. Anyway, if he submitted his test, we're growing. We got people all over the place. Okay. You can do this. You've got to want to, you've got to make the effort to do it. And you got to put in the time and the effort on a consistent basis to cognitively make new change. When that occurs, that will become your autonomic walking gait and you will be way less likely to fall down. That's great. Now, you're not a statistic. Now, your life is not altered. Now, you're not afraid to go and do things. Go on trips, go on hikes, walk on the beach, you know, get into environments where you were cautious prior to because you didn't know if you could stay on your feet, let alone get, you know, down to the riverbed or whatnot. Well, now you've got the abilities and the confidence to go and do that. And hopefully the bone density and the muscle mass enough that if you do fall down, okay, I'm not saying if you do this, you'll never fall down. The ground shifts underneath your feet, right? If you're walking on sand or rock or gravel, I mean, things happen. I get it. If you do fall down, ice, right? We've had tons of ice falls the last 3 years, unfortunately, being this close to Tahoe and such. If you do fall down, we're hoping that your bones are dense enough and your muscles are thick enough and meaty enough to protect you. So if anything, your ego is bruised, but your body is minimally damaged. That's our goal. All right, enough from me. I hope you enjoyed this. I appreciate you all. And that last little bit right here, my favorite part of this whole thing. I'm more of a waddler now when she walks, which you saw the spinning top. The second you get out of balance, what happens? Wobble, wobble, slam. Wobble, wobble, slam. Don't be a wobble, wobble, slammer. You don't want to be that. Much love to everybody out there. Subscribe, like the video, leave comments, share. Okay, send this out to whoever you think could be of value of learning about it. I appreciate you all. Hope you're having a great day, great weekend, great day, wherever you're at, day and night. Thank you for all your love and support. We send it right back to everybody out there in the world. Take care of yourselves. And as always, continue to fight your good fight against sarcopenia. We'll see you in the next one.